This is the world's most expensive coffee, harvested from this cat's ass.
Oh, meta.
Last night I was trying to find the stupidest shit on the internet and found that the most expensive coffee in the world is called Kopi Luwak. We'll cover the details later, but basically this animal called a civet eats the coffee cherries, then poops them out. Then people pick that poop up, roast those beans, and you now have coffee that's $600 a pound.
Oh, I just spent $20 on 2 cups worth of coffee.
My Egyptian family's gonna kill me.
And for reference, most good coffee is like $20 a pound. The shit is so expensive, it has a most expensive-est shit episode with 2 Chainz. It's expensive.
Cat shit coffee.
Yeah. Cat shit coffee, baby.
Now, if you're like me, this sounds pretty dumb. Like, there's no way that cat shit makes your coffee taste that much better. But I also don't know anything about coffee. And in fact, I don't even like coffee.
No, no.
I like it if you add cream and sugar, but that's like saying, oh, I like wine if you add grape juice to it. Like, okay, you don't like wine then. The point is, I want to broaden my horizons. I want to learn to appreciate this cup of coffee if it's really that good. And so we're becoming coffee experts for the next week. If you want to be an expert on something, you have to research. So over the last 4 days, I've read this book, and 97 YouTube videos concerning coffee. I was diagnosed with autism, yes. But on this journey, I found a messiah. I found the coffee wizard. James Hoffman, AKA Coffee Daddy. Through Coffee Daddy's wisdom, I learned that I've never tasted coffee. I was drinking shit. My grinder, shit. My brewing method, shit. I might as well have been girl one on 2 girls, 1 cup. I was drinking so much shit.
Was that too far? That might have been a little too far.
All jokes aside, James Hoffman is a coffee expert on YouTube who talks a lot about the key to this whole thing. Specialty coffee.
Specialty coffee?
The coffee you and me are used to drinking are called commodity coffees. Basically, it's generic coffee. Whether it was grown in Ethiopia or Brazil, no one really cares. But specialty is when you start to treat coffee like a fine wine.
This coffee is a little bit dry. I would say it has a medium body.
Right, this is sort of acid dominant, quite sort of fruit acid flavor. You get a kimchi, my brain would really go more into the world of kombucha and those kind of ferments.
Right. I was just as shocked as you that these people tasted black coffee and then said there's notes of fruit or kombucha. I've never tasted coffee that tasted like anything but fucking shit. So I might have went on a little bit of a shopping spree for specialty coffee. Don't judge me. And I know what you're thinking. Meta, this kind of sounds like hipster douchebag shit. Which, it is. It is, kind of. But before you judge, let me give you a quick crash course on specialty coffee to get you up to pace. We must begin with a history lesson. Boo! Yeah, I know. Deal with it, okay? I'm a nerd. Coffee was first consumed and is native to Ethiopia. The way they consumed it was different. It wasn't the whole processing then roasting method that we know today. That came later, but it was probably in Ethiopia, maybe Yemen, I don't know. Then the Arab world found out about it, became an integral part to Arab culture. But around the 1600s, Europe found out about coffee and shit got crazy. It was a rich man's drink at first. It was expensive, it was exotic, not everyone had access to it, but naturally, poor people found out about it. And the demand skyrocketed. Everyone wanted coffee. The problem with this is that the demand for coffee was so high that there wasn't that many like Yemen was like, guys, Europe, please stop drinking so much coffee. There's not that many coffee plants in the world. Jesus. And then Europe was like, chill, dude. It's not like we don't have slaves. Like, we got it handled. We'll go get coffee somewhere else. That's the story of coffee. But why do we care about all this? I don't know, why do we fucking care about anything? What's the fucking point of anything? All this leads to the 3 types of coffee we drink today. First wave, second wave, and third wave. First wave coffee is what our grandparents knew. It's generic coffee. Is it a light or medium roast? Where was it grown? How fresh is this roast? Who gives a fuck? It's generic coffee. It's just a way to get caffeine.
Literally the only detail this gives you is 100% pure coffee. Wow.
But then, an underdog company by the name of Starbucks came to save coffee in the world. You can choose whether you like a light, medium, or dark roast. You can start drinking fancy, spancy European shit like cappuccino or a latte. Ooh, wow. And it's 100% Arabica beans. But still, no one really cares about a lot of details. They don't care how it was processed, where it was grown, what varietal of coffee it is. It's still just coffee.
But now it's time. Third wave or specialty coffee. This coffee not only tells you that it's from Ethiopia, but from Hambela Guji, Ethiopia. The coffee cherries were processed using the dry processed method. This specific variety is an heirloom variety from Ethiopia, and it was roasted 410, so 10 days ago. And to show you how crazy this gets, I spoke to the CEO of Coffee Black, and he knew his guy in Ethiopia's first name that he gets his coffee from. They knew each other, and that's actually not uncommon. But does it make a difference? What does it taste like? This coffee says it has ripe notes of apricot and cherry candy. Let's see.
Wait, before we get to roasting the coffee, my copy luwak, the cat shit coffee just came in the mail.
Today we're going to be brewing three coffees from three drastically different price points. And I want to say first, there is not a right way to brew coffee. There are wrong ways though. So to save yourself from looking like a dickhead, here's what you need to know. Coffee grinders matter. For example, these suck. In the coffee biz, these are called blade grinders, and they're unanimously hated because they are inconsistent with their grind size. The reason why grind size matters so much is because different grind size actually taste completely different and you have to brew them differently. If I brewed these two grinds for the exact same time and the exact same temperature, this one would probably taste bitter, while this one would probably taste very hollow and almost acidic.
I've actually never done this test before. Oh my god. It's like sour milk sour. I don't really taste a difference. This is bitter, but it's not that much more bitter. Is this all bullshit? Alan, come taste this.
This is your shitty coffee again?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Coffee number one. That's disgusting. Coffee number two.
Do you taste the difference?
The first one has like a more sweeter, it's a little more sweeter.
Do you tell a difference though? Does it taste
more acidic too?
Way more, okay, yes,
the
right?
This one.
Okay.
After tasting some more, me and my dickhead roommate Alan decided that yes, grind size does matter, though it's not super drastic. But this is why generally people don't like blade grinders. So instead, most people use burr grinders, which allow you to be very detailed with your grind size.
And of course, they're way more expensive. This one cost me like $100 fucking, and it's a pretty cheap one.
The vast majority of coffee is water, so don't use shitty tap water. Use a good filtered water at least. There's a lot of people who like go out of their way to use spring water and blah, blah, blah. It's water, but it's a big deal. French press, mocha pot, V60. What I was shocked to find out is that there's not like a superior brew method that everyone's like, oh, that's the best way. Like, your way is the good way. I chose the AeroPress because it seemed like you could nerd out the hardest with it, but it's up to you. There's a lot of other things to keep in mind, but this isn't a fucking James Hoffman video. Just go watch an actual expert. So after weighing the coffee grounds, the water, and making sure everything was consistent coffee to coffee, it's time for the taste test.
Okay.
Hi, so after reviewing the footage, it's not that interesting. I'm just not that interesting alone. So we're gonna have Alan do it, because he's funnier than me. Not cuter, but funnier. I'm funny like Voltaire's Candide. Very, very intellectual. Alan's funny like a puppy eating his own shit, you know?
Alan! Come taste coffee with me.
Let's go.
We're gonna have Alan do it, because he's funnier than me. Not cuter, but funnier. I'm funny like Voltaire's Candide. Very, very intellectual. Alan's funny like a puppy eating his own shit, you know?
You're such an asshole.
It's 1 a.m., but fuck it. Alan's gonna try to figure out which one goes to which blind taste test, okay?
By the way, I'm fucking cuter, and I am not a puppy eating my own fucking shit.
What does that taste like?
It's bitter.
It's bitter? Okay.
That's it.
That's it, just bitterness. Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's just bitter.
I like this one. This one's okay.
Ooh, this one smells like cigarettes. Like burnt wood.
Maybe it's this one.
That's not even in the running.
Okay, well, why do you have it here?
Because I was just, whatever. this is so...
I like that one.
It's so bitter.
I think it's this one. Because I can taste the cherry.
Maybe I'm... You can taste the cherry on that one. Okay, okay. Now try this one.
Ooh, I like this one better.
Right?
Yeah.
This is so good.
Yeah, that one's good.
So, name them. You got instant coffee, Starbucks, and specialty coffee.
This one is the specialty one.
Okay.
And then this one's Starbucks. Okay. And this one's the instant.
Yep. Damn!
Okay, great.
The difference between specialty coffee and ordinary coffee is not subtle. Like, me and Alan do not have refined taste by any means.
They all smell the same to me. Yikes.
Yeah, they all smell the same to me too.
But it was really easy for me and Alan to spot the difference. The difference between the coffees is also really noticeable. Like, this brew I don't really like, but this one's pretty good. And there's like, it's just so fun to taste the different flavors and you're like, oh wow, this has notes of lemon and it's weird. I just realized Alan wrote something very nice on the back of this bag. Aw, the French word for bassoon. Thanks, Alan. Now before we reach the magnus opus of this coffee journey and try the most expensive coffee in the world, there's one more thing we have to address. You see, third wave or specialty coffee
generally produces gentrification. But if we were to compare it with other versions of it, for instance, like if you would get coffee in Ethiopia, it doesn't produce social stratification, it actually brings people together.
Specialty coffee can be pretty douchey. And alongside that, coffee's history is pretty fucked. It includes a lot of slavery and a lot of extortion, and that really hasn't changed much. A lot of the people who farm the coffee that we drink are not treated well and very much underpaid. It's morally gross, and so is Kapi Luwak. I didn't know this when I started this journey, but Kapi Luwak is pretty disgustingly made. They kind of capture these civets and force feed them so many cherries into the point where they're not healthy, just so we can pay an exorbitant amount of money for this coffee. Oh, and much of the Kapi Luwak you buy is fake. There's a pretty good chance that this is completely ordinary coffee that they just passed off as Kapi Luwak. But this is another great reason why you should buy specialty coffee, because even though it might cost a little bit more, the people who made it are getting paid more. Okay, it's time. Let's try some Kapi Luwak.
Okay. The water running. Hold on. Let's open it. You are now in possession of the rarest coffee on earth. Authenticity guarantee. Oh, this is... Hold on, shut the fuck up.
Ooh, wow.
This is to certify that the Kapi Luwak you've purchased from
your mom
is guaranteed to be authentic, wild, oh, and organic. Certificate number 0, oh, wow. If you are going to drink Kapi Luwak, make sure it is wild, and it seems like this company has made it clear that it is wildly grown. Could be totally fake, but whatever. It smells like... It smells all right. I'm pretty excited. Oh, it doesn't smell very good. It smells like vegetables, but I'm not liking it. Oh god, I'm such a douchebag. Coffee's cooled down. Let's try it. Let's do some Mr. Beast stuff. Next 100 people to follow me, I will send you a package of specialty coffee from Coffee Black.
One out of the next 100, not next 100. I'm not actually Mr. Beast. I can't afford that.
It's actually not that bad. It's really well balanced. Cinnamony, a little bit. It's kind of boring. It's not a super interesting, it's not like, there's no notes that are like, wow, I've never tasted that before. It's like, I don't know, it's a good amount of acidity with bitterness. It's not bad, but it's not that interesting. It's not that bad. Cool.